When you need to make a video for your brand or business, it can be challenging to get started. Before you can make interesting and engaging videos that will successfully promote your brand, there's a lot to learn. So why not employ AI to help you create better videos right now? That's what we're going to do today with Designs.AI. Designs.AI is an online design tool that uses AI to help you generate content. They have a variety of tools you can utilize to generate logos, videos, voiceovers, and even designs. As long as you don't resell the individual assets, you're free to use any of your creations, even for commercial purposes. To get started, go to Designs.AI, create a new account, and log in. They have free and paid plans available, and they have a 30-day free trial, which is what I'm using to make this video. The free trial allows you to use all of Design.AI's tools, including VideoMaker, LogoMaker, DesignMaker, and SpeechMaker without restriction for 1 month during the free trial. You can also use the free version, but you'll only have access to a limited number of assets, and your downloaded video will have a watermark. Once you've logged in, select VideoMaker. That will take you to the Projects page, where you can start a new draft, view any projects that have been shared with you, or any videos you've already downloaded. After we generate our video, we'll look at how to share it so any team members can access it and make changes before it's ready to export. Go to Drafts and select the plus icon to begin a new draft. When you select Browse Templates, there are lots of categories available, which are an excellent place to start. But rather than using a template here, we'll generate a video from our script using the Text to Video tab. Let's start by giving our video a title. I'll call it Creating a Video. Next, enter the video script here. You can enter up to 20 sentences with a total of up to 1,500 characters. I'll copy and paste a short script that I prepared. Each sentence needs to end with a period, exclamation point, or question mark, and be on its own line, so make sure to hit enter after each new sentence. The AI will analyze each line and pair it with an appropriate video clip. Shorter sentences tend to work better since they keep the video moving at a rapid pace, keeping the audience's interest. Next, we need to choose our text color. We have a few presets to choose from, or we can choose the colors ourselves. I'll set the text to white, and click Background, and set the background to red. Next, choose an in-screen message, or select Skip. I'll add an in-screen message later. I'll go with Thanks for watching. When you're ready to go on, click the arrow. Next, we can choose an industry. The industry is somewhat similar to a subject or category, which helps the AI identify suitable clips for your video. It will recommend a few that might fit your video, or you can select from the full list. The first suggestion, business and marketing, will be great for our script. Let's move forward again. Here, we can set the language and select a voiceover. Click the speaker icon to hear a sample of the voice you've chosen.
Welcome to VideoMaker. This is my voice sample.
You can select from a wide range of voices with various accents, both male and female. I'll select Amy.
Hi, I'm Amy, and this is my voice sample.
When you press the arrow to advance, the AI will begin creating your video. The video should be finished in 10 to 15 seconds. Let's preview our video and see what the AI has generated for us.
Could you successfully produce an engaging and professional video for your business if you had to do so today? Like many business professionals, you may feel overwhelmed with the task. It might seem impossible to even know where to begin.
Not bad, but it could be even better with some improvements. You could export it now, of course, but let's look at how we can make some changes. First, let's explore the layout of the editing page. The preview panel, located in the center, allows us to preview the video and change some options that we'll explore later, such as adding your own voiceover or logo. You can also select elements on the video preview, like this title text. The options panel, located here on the right, allows you to modify an element or options properties after selecting it. The timeline is located here, and it contains all of the clips that the AI found for our script, as well as the transitions that go between them. You can select a clip by clicking it on the timeline. Each clip has a transition to the following clip, which you can also select by clicking the T box found between the two clips. Then, you can change the transition you'd like to use. Next to the Scenes button, you can see the overall length of your video. If you select a clip on the timeline, you can replace the video on the left in the Assets panel. You can access all of the elements we'll use to construct our video here, including the images, graphics, text, and audio. Now, let's improve the look of our video. We currently have Timeline selected, which displays a timeline with all of our clips laid out sequentially. To move around, click and drag below the clips on the timeline. And to zoom in or out, click and drag above the clips. I prefer using Scenes, which presents each scene as a block with its length in the lower corner. With the intro clip selected, click the Creating a Video text. When an element is selected, you can drag it around to place it, or resize it by dragging from the corner. Drag it up to the upper center region. With the text selected, we can edit its settings in the Options panel. We can set the background color by clicking Elements. I'll leave the text set to white, but let's make it bold. We can change the font to Zen Dots. And let's raise the size to 6. There are various animations you can select, but for this, let's go with Fade Out. Now that we've made some adjustments, let's save our project by clicking Save. The project will auto-save frequently, but I always save it after editing a few sections to make sure I don't lose any of my work. Click on the next clip in the Scenes list, and select the text. The animation is set to fade in, and I want to add a delay so the text appears just as she begins to speak. So let's add a 1 second delay. Preview the video.
Could you successfully produce an engage?
Okay, that looks pretty good. But I want to reduce this text box size a little bit. To edit the text, just double click it. Let's add additional line breaks to help format it more effectively. Okay. Align the text to the right, and drag it down to the lower right corner. Let's try an alternative animation in place of fade in. I'll try fly in from right, and cut the delay to 0.5 seconds.
Could you successfully produce an engaging and professional video for your business if you had to do so today?
Okay, that looks good. Let's move on to the next scene. Double-click the text and format it the same as we did in the last scene. This time, let's align the text to the left and move it to the lower left corner. Set the animation to fly in from the left and give it a 0.5 second delay. What if you wanted to replace this clip with another one that fits the story better? Select the clip in the Scenes list and go to the Assets panel under Videos. You can either click here to search or scroll through the videos and choose one. You can use any of these clips since they are included in your plan, indicated by the small crown icon in the left corner. By choosing Images from the Assets menu, you can select an image to replace the video. As you can see, these have a diamond icon. This means these are premium images, and depending on your plan, you're only permitted to use a certain number of these each month. The basic plan that I'm using allows the use of up to 10 premium images per month. Of course, you can always upload your own photos and videos and use them in your projects. Just click Uploads, and click here to upload your asset. JPEG, PNG, and SVG files are supported when uploading images using VideoMaker. You can use MP4, MOV, AVI, or MPEG for video, and MP3 or WAV files for audio. Use 1920 by 1080 pixels or a 16:9 aspect ratio when uploading video or photos. You won't have any trouble using your uploaded assets in any of the various aspect ratios if you maintain that size. Instead of using my own images or videos, I'll use this clip.
Like many business professionals, you may feel overwhelmed with the task.
Now, in the Options panel, we can resize the new clip to fit the width or height of the video. We can rotate it, or we can mirror the clip. That looks good. Let's add a transition between this clip and the next one. Click on the T between the two scenes you want to transition between. In the Assets panel, you can choose from a variety of animations. If you selected an animation transition, you can change its colors, hue, saturation, or value. As you change its values, a preview of the transition will play. Let's move on to the next clip. If you wanted to get rid of the text for a clip, you can just select it and delete it. We can add a scene effect to zoom out while this clip is playing. And we can choose the anchor point, which is where the camera will zoom from. Let's set it to the center top, and let's lower the zoom to make it less dramatic. In the Assets panel, select the Graphics tab. Here, you can find animated images like GIFs. There are several categories available. Select See All to see all of the graphics in that category. I'll pick Shapes and Lines, and choose this one. After the graphic has been placed in the clip, you can move it around by dragging it or resize it. You can rotate it by clicking and dragging this icon below the image. Let's give this a 1.5 second delay before it's shown on the screen.
It might seem impossible to even know where to begin.
To add text to a clip, select the Text tab in the Assets panel and choose one of the templates. Then, enter your text here. And click Done. I'll make this smaller and rotate it to fit with the video clip. And I'll move it over here. Let's add a delay so it doesn't immediately show up on the screen. Let's go with 2.5 seconds. There are a few clips left, which I'll edit in the same manner as before. There are a few more things to explore before we examine our finished output. Let's head to the Assets panel's Audio tab so we can adjust the music. You can upload your own music here, or you can pick from this collection. To hear a sample of the music, click the play icon and choose the song that best complements your video. I'm going to go with The Road to Success. Click the song to activate it, and set the volume in the Options panel. You might want to add a watermark of your brand or logo to your video. Beneath the video preview, click on Logo. Then, you can upload your logo in the Options panel. Maybe your logo is a plum. Once it's been uploaded, you can resize, rotate, and position it wherever you want, just like the other assets. I'll scale it down and put it in the top left corner. Let's decrease the opacity to about 30% also. Here, you can enable subtitles, and this is how they'll appear. However, they don't work with our video because our text is already visible on the screen. But if you prefer the way they look for your videos, you can remove all the text and enable subtitles. If you have a pro account, you can replace the voiceover if you don't want the automated voice to read your script. Click Voiceover, and then Upload Voiceover. You can still modify the voice volume here, even if you don't have a pro account. One of the best features of Designs.AI's VideoMaker is how simple it is to create videos in different aspect ratios. Currently, there are 4 aspect ratios to choose from: 16 to 9, 9 to 16, 1 to 1, and 4 to 5. 9 to 16 is good for TikTok and Instagram, 1 to 1 is good for Facebook, and 4 to 5 is good for both Facebook and Instagram. All you have to do is change the aspect ratio here, and all of the clips and assets will be converted over. But be careful, the assets will be resized and moved around to make them all fit in the new aspect ratio. So don't just change your video to another ratio to see what it would look like if you already have everything set up the way you want. Instead, go to your projects and clone the project first. That way, you have a backup in case anything gets messed up. to give someone else in your team access to a project so they can work on it remotely, you can click Share, type their email address, and then click the Share button. By clicking the X next to their email, you can remove their access to the project. Alternatively, you can set this project to public by clicking the Private button. You'll be given access to a URL that you can give to anyone you want to give access to the project to. However, you won't be able to remove access for individual users. Instead, you'll need to set the project back to private, which will remove access to anyone who had the link. Now that we've finished our project, we need to download the video. Click on Download, which brings us to this section where we can view our license and our aspect ratio. If you have a pro account and you'd like to generate a PDF storyboard of the video, you can do so by clicking Generate PDF. Let's click Download, and we'll get a confirmation, making sure we've previewed the video before downloading. Click Download again, and it will start processing our video. This will take a few minutes to complete. Once the processing is done, a link will be sent to your email, and shown here. Okay, let's check out the finished product.
Could you successfully produce an engaging and professional video for your business if you had to do so today? Like many business professionals, you may feel overwhelmed with the task. It might seem impossible to even know where to begin. This is frustrating when you understand that video is a vital aspect of marketing, sales, and communication for the growth of your business. That's the problem we aim to solve. Click the link in the description to learn more.
Nice. That's all it takes to create a video using Designs.AI's VideoMaker tool. It's simple and easy to get a usable video quickly, and if you take the time to customize everything, you can make a fantastic video for your project or business. I hope this video was helpful and you found it informative. If it was, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel to show your support. Thanks for watching.